Dear friends, I am Dr. K. Kannan, Professor Mechanical Engineering, Anjali Ammal Mahalingam Engineering College, Koyilvanni. I am happy to meet you again in the video lecture in the subject Gas Dynamics and Jet Propulsion. This is lecture number 23 in Gas Dynamics and Jet Propulsion. We are going to continue with the flow with normal shock. So in the earlier lecture also, we studied the normal shock wave, flow with the normal shock wave, and we continue with the normal shock wave. In the earlier lecture, we studied the types of shock waves and the governing equation. We derived the Prandtl-Meyer equation and we calculated the Mach number on the downstream of the shock wave. And in this lecture, we will study the property change across the shock wave and we derive the Rankine-Hogan-Yart equation. The learning outcome to the students, at the end of the lecture, the student will be able to derive the Rankine-Hogan-Yart equation and calculate the property change across the normal shock wave. The first property change, static pressure ratio across the normal shock wave. So for normal shock wave, we know PFX equal to FY. We derived earlier in the governing equation, impulse, the momentum. From the momentum equation, we concluded the impulse function is constant across the shock wave. FX equal to FY. And substituting PX plus rho X CX square equal to PY plus rho Y CY square. That is FX and FY value. And we take Px outside, so this becomes 1 Px into 1 plus gamma mx square equal to Py plus into 1 plus gamma my square. So Py by Px, the pressure ratio across the shock wave, Py by Px equal to 1 plus gamma mx square divided by 1 plus gamma my square. And substituting the value of my square and simplifying, we will get Py by Px equal to 2 gamma by gamma plus 1 mx square minus gamma minus 1 by gamma plus 1. So this is the equation for pressure change across the shock wave, and we plot the equation with respect to the upstream Mach number mx. So mx is the Mach number before the shock wave, and Py by Px is the pressure change. When the Mach number at the entrance is 6, the pressure ratio is somewhere in near 40. So the Py pressure on the downstream side of the shock wave is 40 times of the pressure on the upstream side of the shock wave. So we may find that there is tremendous or more pressurized across the shock wave. And the static temperature ratio across the normal shock wave. From the adiabatic energy equation for the normal shock wave for ideal gas, we know TOX equal to TOY. So we derived in the energy equation, we said HOX equal to HOY. So for gases, H equal to Cp into T, so TOX equal to TOY, and the static temperature ratio across the normal shock wave is given as TY by TX equal to TY by TOY into TOX by TX, because we know TOX equal to TOY, that is getting cancelled. Now you substitute for the value TY by TOY and TOX by TX, TY by TX equal to 1 plus gamma minus 1 by 2 mx square divided by 1 plus gamma minus 1 by 2 my square. And in this equation, you substitute the value of my square and simplifying, Ty by Tx equal to 1 plus gamma minus 1 by 2 mx square into 2 gamma by gamma minus 1 mx square minus 1 divided by gamma plus 1 whole square divided by 2 into gamma minus 1 into mx square. And we plot the variation of the temperature, static temperature ratio across the shock wave for with respect to the inlet Mach number. So mx equal to inlet Mach number. So the static temperature is also steeply changing. Density and velocity ratio across the normal shock wave. So the density ratio across the normal shock wave is given by rho y by rho x from the perfect gas equation. Rho y by rho x equal to Py by Px into Tx by Ty. And the substituting for Py by Px and Tx by Ty and the simplify. Substitute the values of static pressure ratio and static temperature ratio and simplifying, will get rho y by rho x equal to gamma plus 1 by 2 mx square divided by 1 plus gamma minus 1 by 2 mx square. And from the continuity equation, cy by cx equal to rho x by rho y, which is equal to the reciprocal value 1 plus gamma minus 1 by 2 mx square divided by 1 gamma plus 1 by 2 mx square. And the variation of density ratio with respect to Mach number. So inlet Mach number is mx, the density ratio is also linearly changing. And the Rankine-Hogan-Yart equations. So the This is again important equation for the normal shock wave. The upstream Mach number from the static pressure ratio, from the we derived the static pressure ratio P y by Px. So from that the upstream Mach number is Mx square equal to gamma plus 1 by 2 gamma P y by Px plus gamma minus 1 by 2 gamma. Substituting the value in the static temperature equation, so T y by Tx equal to 1 plus gamma minus 1 by 2 into gamma plus 1 by 2 gamma P y by Px plus gamma plus 1 by 2 gamma multiplied by 2 gamma by gamma minus 1 into gamma plus 1 by 2 gamma P y by Px plus gamma minus 1 by 2 2 gamma whole divided by gamma plus 1 whole square divided by 2 into gamma minus 1 multiplied by gamma plus 1 by 2 gamma P y by Px plus gamma plus 1 by 2 gamma. So this is the temperature ratio. So simplifying and rearranging the terms. So T y by Tx equal to P y by Px into 1 plus gamma minus 1 by 2 gamma minus 1 by gamma plus 1 P y by Px divided by P y by Px plus gamma minus 1 by gamma plus 1. Or we have another term. You bring the P y by Px to the downstream side. So we will get P y by Ty into Tx by Px. P y by Ty divided by into Tx by Ty equal to P y by Px plus gamma minus 1 by gamma plus 1 divided by 1 plus gamma minus 1 by gamma plus 1 into P y by Px. So this from here we rearrange the terms. So this rho y by rho x equal to gamma plus 1 by gamma minus 1 P y by Px divided by gamma plus 1 by gamma minus 1 plus P y by Px, and P y by Px equal to gamma plus 1 by gamma minus 1 rho y by rho x minus 1 divided by gamma plus 1 by gamma minus 1 minus rho y by rho x. And the above equations, the density ratio and pressure ratio in terms of pressure ratio, rearranging the terms. So the density ratio in terms of pressure ratio and the pressure ratio in terms of density ratio, they are known as Rankine-Fagundian equations. Stagnation pressure ratio across the normal shock wave. So the stagnation pressure ratio across the normal shock wave is given as PO by PYX equal to POY by PY into PY by PX into PX by PYX. So substituting all the values PO by PY, PX by PY for the normal shock wave, PX by POX is the ratio of static to stagnation pressure ratio. Substituting all the values and simplifying, we'll get PO by PYX equal to gamma plus 1 by 2 mx square divided by 1 plus gamma minus 1 by 2 mx square whole to the power gamma by gamma minus 1 into 2 gamma by gamma plus 1 mx square minus gamma minus 1 by gamma plus 1 to the power minus 1 by gamma minus 1. And this is the variation of stagnation pressure ratio with respect to the inlet Mach number mx. So the values are decreasing. Mach number, when the Mach number is high increasing, the pressure ratio, stagnation pressure ratio is decreasing. Then stagnation to static pressure ratio for a normal shock wave, across the normal shock wave, POY by PX equal to POY by PY into PY by PX. And substituting and simplifying, we will get POY by PX equal to gamma plus 1 by 2 mx square to the power gamma by gamma minus 1 into 2 gamma by gamma plus 1 mx square minus gamma minus 1 by gamma plus 1 to the power 1 by gamma minus 1. So this is again, this property, everything is available in the normal shock table. And this is how the stagnation to static pressure is varying with respect to Mach number for gamma equal to 1.4. And entropy change across the normal shock wave. So the change of entropy across the normal shock wave is given as delta S equal to Sy minus X equal to Cp into logarithmic of Ty by Tx minus R into logarithmic of Py by Px. And again Cp into logarithmic of Ty by Tx. The R is replaced by Cp into gamma minus 1 by gamma into logarithmic of Py by Px. So this equation we can write as Cp into logarithmic of Ty by Tx divided by Py by Px to the power gamma minus 1 by gamma. So from the definition of Px by Px and Py by Py, Py by Px equal to Ty by Tx to the power gamma by gamma minus 1 into Py by Px. Now rearranging Py by Px to the power gamma minus 1 by gamma equal to Ty by Tx into Py by Px to the power gamma minus 1 by gamma. So rearranging Ty by Tx divided by Py by Px to the power gamma minus 1 by gamma equal to Py by Px to the power minus gamma minus 1 by gamma. Now, so here this term you may find in the delta S equation, and This therefore delta S equal to Cp in the logarithmic of PO by POX minus to the power minus gamma minus 1 by gamma. This you can write as delta S equal to minus R into logarithmic of POY by POX. The change in entropy across the normal shock wave equal to minus R into logarithmic of the change in stagnation property across the shock wave. And substituting PO by POX, the equation becomes delta S equal to R into multiplied by gamma minus 1 logarithmic of 2 by gamma plus 1 into mx square plus gamma minus 1 by gamma plus 1 plus 1 by gamma minus 1 into logarithmic of 2 gamma by gamma plus 1 mx square minus gamma minus 1 by gamma plus 1. We plot the variation of change in entropy with respect to Mach number on the upstream side. So this is how the Mach number, the entropy changes in the shock wave. And there are two part of the curve. One is entropy change, here it is 0. So approximately you take Mach number equal to 1. So the after Mach number, when the Mach number is greater than 1, the entropy changes, there is increase in entropy or decrease in entropy depending on the shock wave. Whereas here the entropy change is positive, whether this is increasing or decreasing, it is positive. Whereas when the Mach number is less than 1, the entropy change is negative. This observation is required. So we take Mach number equal to 1. When the Mach number is greater than 1, that is for supersonic flow, whether this is entropy change is positive, whereas Mach number is less than 1, the entropy change is negative. You keep the values in your mind. Subsonic, supersonic flow, the entropy change is positive, and the subsonic flow, the entropy change is negative. And this impossibility of shock wave in the subsonic flow. So from the entropy change of equation, if the Mach number is mx equal to 1, delta S equal to 0. For subsonic flow, when the Mach number is less than 1, then the entropy change will take negative value, represent decrease in entropy, which is not possible as per second law of thermodynamics. Entropy change will not take a negative value. So this is not possible. So therefore, there is no, it is impossible for a shock wave to develop in the subsonic flow. At the entrance of the duct, when the flow is subsonic, there is no possibility of shock wave. Right? So nozzle, there is no possibility of shock wave. But in the diffuser, at the entrance, the flow is supersonic, definitely there will be a possibility of shock wave. So in the subsonic region, there is no possibility of shock wave. And the strength of the shock wave. The strength of the shock wave is defined as the ratio of increase in static pressure across the shock wave to the upstream pressure. So beta is the strength of the shock wave, Py minus Px divided by Px, which is also, we may write as Py by Px minus 1. So substituting for static pressure ratio, beta equal to 2 gamma by gamma plus 1 into mx square minus 1. This is the strength of the shock wave. So substituting the mx value and the gamma value, we can calculate the strength of the shock wave. And the shock condensation, it is another parameter. Shock condensation is defined as the ratio of increase in density across the shock to the upstream density of the fluid. So for example, delta equal to rho y minus rho x divided by rho x. So rho y minus rho x is the increase in density across the shock wave divided by rho x is the upstream density of the fluid. Shock condensation. And the shock wave, the concept of shock wave is used to measure the property change, POY by PX in a pitot tube. So in a pitot tube, at the tip of the pitot tube, the flow is stagnant flow. The properties are stagnant, POY. So here the properties are static properties. So the pressure is, here it is PX. We call it as PX and this is POY. And the ratio POY by PX equal to 1 plus gamma. So this equation already we derived. 1 gamma plus 1 by 2 into mx square to the power gamma by gamma minus 1. Into 2 gamma by gamma plus 1 into mx square minus gamma minus 1 by gamma plus 1 to the power 1 by gamma. So this is the, so from this equation we can calculate the POY or POY by PX ratio once you know the Mach number and the upstream side of the pitot tube. And this is the properties value for gamma equal to 1.4. So there is normal shock table. So like Fanon flow table, Rayleigh flow table and isothermal flow table. Isentropic flow table, we have the flow properties for normal shock wave for different values of gamma. So this is the example table for gamma equal to 1.4. So when you know the mx, the pressure, Mach number at the entrance of the shock wave, beginning of the shock wave, we can take the directly we can take my py by px, dy by tx, poy by poyx and poy by px. So all the properties we can change. From these properties we can find out the unknown in the problem. So we stop here. So these are all the books I have written in mechanical engineering subject. You may find the gas enemies and jet propulsion book, and you use the book for additional information on the subject or numerical examples in the subject. So in the next lecture we may solve problems across the normal shock wave, and I upload the video lectures of all the subjects in the YouTube channel. You subscribe the channel, use the videos for your better learning. So thank you for watching. Please post your comments on the comments box. You can contact me through my WhatsApp number or email ID for further clarification on the subject.